Hello and welcome to this video from The Banker. I am Barbara Pianese, Latin America editor at The Banker, and I am delighted to be here today with the governor of the Central Bank of Uruguay, Diego Labat, who was also awarded by The Banker as Central Banker of the Year 2023 for the Americas. So I think it's quite interesting that Uruguay in this year in April was the first country in Latin America to decrease the interest rates. I don't know if you can tell me more about this dynamic. Of course, this was probably the result of a drop or a deceleration in inflation, but also a drop in economic activity.
We have been very clear with the market that we evaluate very positively the evolution of inflation and its expectation. And it will allow us to go forward and to decrease the rates in the future. Mm-hmm. But we have been very clear that it is a slow process. It depends on the future data. We are looking very close numbers of inflation and numbers of expectation. And then, if it is possible, we will decrease the rates as we need it. So, the most important is to preserve the credibility of the central bank and to preserve the trend that we are taking now of a decrease in inflation and a decrease in inflation expectation.
The central bank has been criticized by exporters about the fact that borrowing costs are also causing the peso to appreciate. And so last year, the national currency appreciated 12%, and this year is also appreciating. So I was just wondering, how would you respond to these critics?
Uruguay has a free floating regime that I think that it is the best regime that a small and open country as Uruguay can have. I think it is necessary, the free floating regime, to attend the shocks that the economy received from external things, and about the monetary conditions, I think that during the pandemic, the monetary conditions was so expensive. We tried to maintain the economic activity functioning and just at the pandemic, but now I think that it is the time to tighten monetary conditions and to go for the goal of inflation that I mentioned. No?
And going back a little bit in time, in 2020, the Central Bank of Uruguay reintroduced after 7 years the monetary policy rate, after years where it was controlling the inflation, more handling the monetary supply. So I was just wondering how this change came about and what have been the impact.
Well, in 2020, we introduced a lot of changes in monetary policy to improve the credibility of central bank. This is the main objective of the measures. We named this project Towers a Quality Currency. It is the name. For us, it is important to fix this idea about the quality currency. There's a lot of measures. For example, we introduced a lot of changes in communication, doubling the frequency of the Monetary Policy Committee, and other things. Just we are working on de-dollarization of the economy, a lot of things. And perhaps one of the most important changes was the introduction of the interest rate as the instrument of the monetary policy. The interest rate, it's a better signal, a better and more transparent signal to the economic agents. I think that the economic agents react with our signals if we fix the interest rate. I think the impact of the overall changes in the monetary policy and of the interest rate was very positive. I think that during the world inflation shock, we maintain inflation in Uruguay in one single digit, and now, till 8 months, we are in a path of downsides of inflation till now outside the target range, but in a trajectory that we are confident that it will continue. All the market recognize this, and I think we are in the right way.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Barbara.